Chicane, I'm moving in on Rucker's position. You got those coordinates yet?
I'll transmit them as soon as I've finished my coffee.
Don't leave me hanging, Chicane.
You just worry about getting our man. And be careful. He's dangerous.
We'll see.
I'm Anom.
I'm sure you'll understand if I don't take your word for it. As the customary final request of the condemned man, please, do not kill any more of my people on the way out. Their only crime against you is their loyalty to me. You're such a precious hero. I'm not. After the train station attacks, I knew it was only a matter of time before they sent someone. Please, take this is a social call, Rucker. I'm gonna take you in. Our mandate is to fight for the rights of the augmented. Communicate our message, offer assistance. The Ark is a non-violent organization.
All right, then this should be easy. Come with me, answer our questions, and we'll have you back here in plenty of time to film your next sermon.
I'm not a fool. If I surrender now, I'm never coming back. Once you have me, you intend to make me disappear. But I will not make Solzhenitsyn's mistake. My people and I will resist you.
I thought you were a pacifist.
I am. But I'm more than a leader. I'm a symbol. That is why you wish to erase me. If martyrdom is the only way to remain a symbol, then even my death is preferable to my evaporation.
You said you don't want any more of your people getting hurt. If I have to bring you in by force, I will. And they're going to try to stop me. There's a better chance of avoiding violence if you come along peacefully. You have my word. I will do everything I can to see that you're treated fairly.
How dare you speak to me of peace and fairness? You assaulted innocent people to get in here and kidnap me on behalf of masters who hide in the shadows, manipulating, controlling, and murdering without the courage to proclaim their convictions in front of the rest of the world.
You're not any different from them, Rucker. All of you rely on armed men while spotting your rhetoric from behind the safety of a camera. If you want to prove the strength of your convictions, confront your enemies face to face.
Well, you seem to be more than the unquestioning brute I took you for. It is refreshing to hear that kind of passion and idealism in other people, particularly after everything I've experienced lately. I have been patient and understanding. I have taught my people non-violence and waited for the rest of the world to follow that example. I've had faith in humanity, and humanity betrayed me.
Follow your example. History has shown that anti-other movements always spring up in times of chaos and fear. Before deciding to become a symbol of the cause, you should have made sure you were prepared for it.
I thought I was. I thought I could. God help me, someone had to do it. This is a very precarious time for the movement. These attacks are making everything worse for us. My leadership position within ARC is being threatened, and I suspect the two might even be connected. Please, go back to your people. Tell them to give me 48 hours so I can attempt to resolve the internal conflict.
I'm sorry. If I go back empty-handed, I'll just be replaced, probably by someone more eager and less sympathetic. Coming in now is honestly the best thing you can do for everyone.
Yes, I suspect you're right. But can you understand this? If you were to take me from here, you would be responsible for more than my death. You would be responsible for my effacement, the ruination of the Augmented Rights Coalition, and the perversion of everything it stands for.
The bottom line hasn't changed. If you come with me willingly, there won't be any violence. You now have the choice. Choose a non-violent path, or you are the one betraying the cause.
I cannot watch any more of my people die. Not on my account. You've asked me to trust you, and so I will. Before we leave together, there's something I must show you. I suspect there's a power struggle brewing within our organization. Some people inside ARC are less committed to our ideals.
Are you trying to tell me you know who's responsible for the bombings?
I have only suspicions, and until recently, not even that. The evidence I have begun collecting is meager, but I give it to you. This is the key card for the security door. The evidence is inside.
Why give it to me? Why not keep it, present it at your interrogation?
Because if my suspicions are correct, and I'm seen leaving here with you willingly, I may not survive to present my evidence.
Somewhere down there, hiding in plain sight, is your real terrorist. I was trying, secretly, to find out who is responsible.
Rucker? Rucker is dead.
Come again.
I'll fill you in when I see you, which is where exactly?
There's some greenhouses near your position. Below them is a clearing. That's where I'll be. Chicane out.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated. Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated. Access granted. Access granted.
Ourselves with the Second Amendment.
Jensen, the meter's running. Where the hell are you?
I'm on my way, Chicane.
Well, step it up.
Good Rucker being dead is going to do for us. Your orders were to bring him in.
I fully intended to. Then how did this happen? I think someone being paid to manipulate Ark killed her. Someone in his crew. Rucker told me Ark was being set up, but the real terrorists were hiding in plain sight.
And was he wearing a tinfoil hat when he said this?
The man was devoted to bridging the divide between ours and naturals. He knew that every one of his attacks just drives the stake in deeper, and that the only way to fix things was to pull that stake out. He said he had evidence to prove Ark's innocence. He was ready to come and talk to us, even though he knew he'd never seen his life.
What evidence was he referring to?
I don't know. He was killed before he could say.
Well then, there's no use theorizing over what-ifs, is there?
What about Victor Marchenko?
I ran that name through Irene and got back a blank page. Why? You got something else?
Nothing more than a gut feeling, so far.
Well, I'm sorry, Agent, but I need more than that. Christ, what a mess. You know word of Rucker's death is going to spread, don't you? And when that happens, the head of state police assures me Golem City will become a war zone. We can't let that happen. I hope we're good on juice, Chicane, because I need a ride. As for you, Agent.
I still have a case to solve, and I know exactly where to start, Director. Smiley's had more than enough time to analyze that DSD I gave him.
The one you took from Rizika?
I'll check in with him, see what's on. After that, I'll go where the evidence takes me. I intend to make sure the right people are brought to justice for this, whether they're augmented or not.
Get a move on, before this case gets any colder, and keep me in the loop. Let's go, Chicane.
Tell us Rucker's dead.
What?
Poisoned, I think.
Holy shit, man. Rucker was the voice of the augmented. People loved him for it. One word of this hits, Prague is gonna explode.
And the whole world's watching. Listen, Miller's gone to meet with state police. Could be our chance to determine his loyalties.
He lives near TF-29. You want us to search his apartment?
Not us. Me. You keep digging into that VersaLife break-in. And see what the Collective can dig up on a Victor Marchenko. If I'm right, and Rucker was poisoned, all three might be connected. Jensen out.